Good morning, everyone. I'm Dan Smith. I'm president and CEO of Cooperative Network. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar, which is on a very timely subject. We've all need to learn on the last couple of months, new ways of conducting business. And as is evident through our Zoom meeting today, that is often through virtual meetings. So how do you protect your business information, the proprietary knowledge that exists within your cooperative, and how do you protect not only your cooperative as a whole, but also your customers and your members? So we're very pleased today to be working with M3 Insurance, and I'm going to turn it over to Katie Ott, who is the head of Workside Practice at M3 Insurance, to kind of lead us off, and then we'll work with Scott Hudson on the presentation. Thank you.
Sounds great. Thank you, Dan. Good morning. My name is Katie Ott. I lead the worksite benefits practice of the employee benefits division at M3 Insurance. And what this means is I specialize in the types of insurance products that employees typically can choose to buy through their employer. I find myself shifting gears just a little bit this morning because our discussion is a result of the unique and important relationship between M3 and the cooperative network. M3 and the Co-op Network have partnered for several years to bring resources and information to Co-op Network members about all aspects of risk management and insurance. M3 is an independent, shareholder-owned insurance brokerage that is a strong supporter of the cooperative movement. In the past, our team has partnered with the Cooperative Network to educate members like you on topics ranging from employee benefits compliance to business continuity planning to crisis management. We are so happy to support the Cooperative Network and their members in bringing cutting-edge resources directly to cooperatives and their employees. Today, we'll hear from Scott Hudson from Aurora Identity Guard about a new and increasingly important topic, as Dan referenced, particularly in the age of remote work, cybersecurity, and identity theft protection. Scott will not only educate us about this rapidly evolving space and the risks that come with it, he'll explain the special partnership offer that will soon be available for Co-op Network member employees to help address those risks. So Scott, I'll turn it to you.
Awesome. Thank you, Katie, and thank you, Dan. I appreciate the opportunity and look forward to communicating the program with all of you. So first, want to just introduce you to Aura. Aura is a relatively new company, but we've been focused in the identity theft space for some 25 years through various acquisitions. And our goal and mission is to create the first and only unified integrated cyber wellness platform. And we'll talk more about that term cyber wellness in a few minutes. But a place where employees can go to get protection for not only their identity, but their devices, their Wi-Fi, and their privacy, because we're all under attack today. So we're excited to be here in partnership with M3 to bring this program to you. So as we've talked, or as mentioned earlier, identity theft is one of the most ignored problems out there. It happens and we don't even know it. But to put identity theft in perspective, a car is stolen every 6.5 minutes. A burglary happens every 15 seconds. Someone's identity is stolen every 2 seconds. This can be credit card fraud, this can be unemployment fraud, and the list goes on and on. And unfortunately, the bad guys continue to get better and better and better. And now with COVID, as mentioned earlier, I mean, we live online. Obviously, this presentation is online, and you know, I live on Zoom all day and conference calls and everything we do. I mean, we go to the doctor online, we bank online, we do everything. But with COVID, the scams and the cyber criminals have raised their game. They're trying to steal government checks. I mean, there's talks now about a new stimulus program. Well, the cyber criminals are already waiting to begin to figure out how they can attack and steal those checks. Phishing scams, particularly targeted to elderly people, calling and asking and verifying personally identifiable information. These folks are smart, they're innovative, and they're constantly looking for ways to take advantage of folks. And they use COVID. They use that as a disguise to get people riled up. And now one of the fastest growing is unemployment fraud. It's a problem in every state, particularly in specific states where individuals are actually going out and stealing our identity, collecting unemployment from us as we're employed. And then if we're one of those individuals that loses our job, we go to apply and come to find out we're denied because someone is already collecting unemployment in our name. This obviously impacts the company, but it certainly impacts each of us if we need those benefits to pay our bills. And what the FBI is saying is cybercrime is up 300% since the pandemic, and we don't see it stopping. So one of the things that Katie mentioned is one of the programs that we would like to offer to everyone and all of your employees that are benefit eligible is the ability to get free identity theft until the end of February 2021. So basically, we would offer our premier product available to an individual for them to monitor their identity. And if they're a victim of identity theft, they have the ability to call our remediation team and have them help them solve it. So this is an important benefit that the organization is bringing to everyone that is part of the network. So we hope all of you take advantage of it. It's an incredible offer to be able to protect you and then ultimately your family. So as we mentioned earlier, we all are trading privacy for convenience, whether you're using Facebook, Google, Uber, then the list goes on. Every time you go in and you collect those terms and conditions, which none of us ever read, basically we're giving people access to our information to use it. And then what happens is the hackers, they want to go out and exploit it. And some of the biggest breaches in history, Equifax, Chase, Home Depot, and Marriott. And in full transparency, I worked at Equifax when the breach at Equifax happened. And I felt like we had incredible security there. But these guys outsmarted us and they were able to secure 140 million records, most of it in the US, but some in UK and Canada. And that information is out there being used or exposed. And it happened at Home Depot, it happened at Marriott, it happened at Chase, it happened at all of these different places. And what's happened is that information then is commoditized, it's sold. You'll hear the term deep web or dark web. And this is the underpinning under the traditional web that we all are sitting here reviewing this presentation today. But there's a marketplace where a social security number or a credit card number or your address, your phone number, your email, they have values and people buy those. And it's not a matter of if your data is going to be exposed. It has. Everybody's data is out there. The key question here is, do you and your family have protection to alert you when something has been compromised and then have resources to help you fix it if you're a victim? So that's what we're really here to talk about. So when we think about it, you know, how are we as employees and our family impacted? Your identity is stolen, unauthorized lines of credit, financial loss of accounts, credit score impacted. One of the fastest growing forms of identity theft, believe it or not, is home title transfer. People actually are able to get a hold of your title and go out and secure lines of credit against it. And we talked about fraudulent unemployment. But this extends from each of us to our family. Identity theft coverage impacts kids below 18. One of the big victims are young children. Their social security number is compromised. They turn 18 and then they come to find out that there's loans, grandparents, your parents, it can delay acquiring, getting access to student loans or being accepted into college. Elderly people getting in for elder care, loss of inheritance. And then, as I mentioned earlier, someone turns 18, ready to start their life and come to find out that there's $200,000 in debt in their name. And all of this is something that can be tracked. You know, as I mentioned earlier, the FBI is stating that 300% increase in cybercrime. The issue here is, though, traditional identity theft at its most basic level is not enough. You really need to think beyond identity theft and think of identity, device, Wi-Fi, and privacy protection. Those are the things that that really matter. And lastly, just for putting things into perspective, you know, I was on a call yesterday with an employer, and they were talking about offering pet insurance. And you know, I'm a big pet owner. My dog is sitting here under my feet, and I'm praying that he won't bark here on the call. But you know, pet insurance. Well, only 85 million or 25% of the population has a pet. So offering pet insurance is great, but it doesn't address the full problem. Student loan, paid legal services. All of these are great benefits that address a problem for a specific population. But all of us have had our data exposed, and all of us are going to be victims of identity theft. It's just a matter of when and the degree. So having a benefit like this is vital to protecting you and your family. I mentioned the term cyber wellness earlier, and this is a new term that we're using. But the whole total well-being concept is not new. Many, many employers are working with their employees to drive a total well-being culture, which includes physical wellness, you know, monitoring what we eat, how we eat, heart rates, et cetera. Obviously focused on financial wellness, trying to improve our credit score, making good decisions on our finances, investing in 401k or 403b programs. And now what's really becoming a major play is mental wellness and getting access to services, whether it's through an employee assistance program or many of the other services are out there. But at the end of the day, all of these are impacted because of our cyber behavior. I bank online, I do my finances online, I go to the doctor online. If I want to talk to a therapist, I'm going to probably do it online in today's environment. So all of our information is exposed. And so what you need to do is think about, are you protecting your identity, your devices, your Wi-Fi, your privacy, even your social reputation and your assets? And so this is where we believe cyber wellness deserves its own seat at the table as part of a total well-being program. So how do you achieve cyber wellness? It's not easy. And as I mentioned, identity theft, whether it's credit alerting and monitoring and account monitoring and dark web monitoring, all very important, but it's only a piece of the puzzle, and it's typically reactive to something that's happened. You know, think about the laptop, the tablet, your cell phone, your browsing. What are you doing to protect yourself and your family there? Your home network. As I sit here and work on my home network, my company provides me a secure environment with my work computer to do this particular conversation. But my wife is using her iPad, maybe without up-to-date protection. My son just came home from college because of COVID. You know, what kind of protection does he have? And is that putting me potentially at risk or my company at risk? My social reputation. I mean, we put our lives out there on Facebook and other places. Security settings, looking at those and making sure that we're not, you know, putting too much information on Facebook or LinkedIn or Google or whomever. And people are committing crimes in our name, which prevent us from getting jobs and doing things. You know, are you getting all of those things monitored? We already talked about assets and home titles and retirement, but privacy, data aggregators. I mean, our information is sold like on a stock market, and every time you go out there and click. And so having a tool that can go out and remove your information proactively so that it reduces your, as I look out the window, your junk mail in the mailbox, or your robocalls, or your spam and other things. And then lastly, we talked about family, protecting your children, protecting your parents, your grandparents. And unfortunately, with children, this latest, it's not new, but it's certainly growing, cyberbullying. You know, kids live online. Bullying used to happen at the bus stop or when you got off the bus after school or on the playground. Now it happens in this digital world. and people team up, and unfortunately some awful things are happening to children. So one of the things that we do is we can alert parents leveraging IBM Watson to make very specific alerts to parents that something's going on strange within their child's accounts. And this is the path to cyber wellness. And what we believe that each individual employee out there and each company should be thinking about and trying to help their employees. But it's not easy because there's many products out there to choose from within the identity theft space, within device protection, within social reputation, within Wi-Fi and VPN and antivirus and protecting our assets and then protecting our privacy. So there's hundreds of options. There's multiple products, support lines, credit card bills, invoices, logins, and it can get quite expensive. And so what Aura is bringing to the table is one integrated platform under our ultimate plan. And we have multiple products because not everybody needs the ultimate plan. We have something called Total, Premier, and Ultimate. We'll talk about that in a minute. But our ultimate plan brings identity protection, best-in-class device protection, and privacy. And all of those are available for $19.85 per month with one product, one support line, one bill, one logon option, and compared to if you were to go out and piecemeal those things together. So if you think about traditional credit monitoring and identity theft, which is so, so important, but I just want to drive home, it's not enough. You need more, but you do need credit monitoring. You need to be able to check your credit reports and scores, and you need to monitor transactions in bank accounts and dark web monitoring. My son, I just included him on the program, and he immediately received 6 alerts upon logging in that his username and credentials were compromised at 6 different sites through dark web monitoring. And I immediately said, well, did you change your username and passwords on the current site you're using? He goes, no, I don't use those sites anymore, so I'm not worried about it. But this is how these cyber criminals get access to our information. And these authentication alerts, and back to family plans, put your family members on. I have my 2 sons and they're 26 and 27. I have my wife and I have my mother. I can't see their information, but I am notified that they have an alert, so I can say something to them. And then all of that is backed by a dedicated support line. So you get on the phone when you're stressed out about this event and they talk you through it and they help you. And then ultimately, if it's a legitimate issue, they help you resolve it, and they're there to work you through the process all the way through. And then if you are a victim, there's insurance there to help offset some of that cost, whether that's time, whether that's legal fees or actual assets that are lost. So those are the basics. But as I mentioned, not necessarily enough. And 2, what we're doing is bringing more to the table. These are some things that we do that nobody else in the space does. 1, we're connected to all 3 credit bureaus. May not seem big, but most of our competitors are typically connected to 1. There's 3 bureaus. There's Equifax, there's TransUnion, and there's Experian. Most identity theft providers are connected to 1, some 2, nobody to all 3. But if you go in, and I did this recently, I went in to buy some furniture. And within Identity Guard, I received an alert within 4 seconds. As soon as I hit the button, apply, I received notification that there was an inquiry on my credit and that a potential account was created. That's because I'm connected to all 3. If I was using a product that, say, is only leveraging TU, TransUnion, and that particular merchant was only looking at or only using Equifax, it could be 8 hours, 12 hours, 15 hours before I received that alert. And guess what? The bad guy has already bought something, taken it out of the store, and then you're left there to clean that up. I mentioned IBM Watson. So we're leveraging artificial intelligence. It's monitoring. We're going to ask information about you. What are your browsing activities? What are your home network providers? What type of cell phone? What types of devices? What type of internet browser? Who do you bank with? Who do you have insurance with? we're going to ask these questions because what's going to happen is IBM Watson is going to go out and look for information that's relevant to you because of that information to make you aware that something's going on that could put you or your family at risk. It's not being invasive. It's just being able to help take all of this information and bring it down to very, very personalized threat alerts, which I mentioned over on the right, that may be relevant to you. And then we have unparalleled family protection. We have enhanced risk management. And then other types of things related to device and safe browsing and all of these other things that are going on within our world. We're here to protect it and help you and your family, whether it's safe browsing or device or Wi-Fi and identity and privacy. So those are the things that we do. And our goal here is to move beyond just providing an alert on something that's happened, much like a fire alarm. It goes off when there's smoke in your house. We want to actually try to stop the fire before there's ever smoke and stop the identity theft or the cybercrime before the cyber criminal is able to execute it to protect you and your family. And so that's what we're trying to do. So these identity thieves, you know, they're looking to wreak havoc for you and your family. And just examples, you know, payment dues, credit destroyed, unable to get your dream job. I mean, there are companies that actually check your credit before you are employed. And if you're a victim of identity theft, your credit score could plummet, prevent you from getting a job, maybe even be an issue that could cause you to lose your job, loss of retirement savings or other funds. IRS, I mean, tax refunds are one of the more significant forms of identity theft. I mean, it's so bad that the IRS tells you to get your return in early so that you minimize the risk of being a victim. And now with new stimulus money coming, these guys, these cyber criminals are ready and they will pounce on trying to get access to that. Civil or criminal charges, health insurance services revoked, and obviously all of your government benefits, whether it's unemployment or other things. We're under attack. And so we need to take the appropriate steps to protect ourselves. A couple of slides before we end. We recently did some research with the Identity Theft Resource Center, which is a nonprofit organization. And what we were trying to find out is through them, you know, are employees using these types of products? And more importantly, are employees that do use them seeing value? And I have to be honest, the results came back, quite frankly, significantly higher than we ever expected. 83% of employees that use a product like this say the employer provided services help them restore their identity if they were a victim. 78% reported their ID theft protection voluntary benefit improved their quality of life. Nearly 90% stated the solution enabled them to stay engaged at work when they were a victim, because it can take days and weeks to try to resolve these. Another 90% recommended the benefit to coworkers, and nearly 80% reported the ID theft protection benefit reduced their overall stress. So the good news is the employees that have access to a benefit like this or choose to purchase a benefit like this are seeing great value. And it is one of the more quickly growing voluntary benefits out there that that organizations are looking to make available to their employees. As far as pricing, I believe this is my last slide. And obviously, if we have any questions, we'll be happy to take them. But we have three products. We have what we call Total, Premier, and Ultimate. Ultimate, obviously, is the ultimate product that includes all three components: full and most robust identity theft, privacy protection, where we're proactively going out and removing your information from data brokers and third-party sites, and alerting you of potential situations where you are compromised. And then device protection, putting antivirus and VPN and other safe browsing tools available on your, remember, this is for personal devices. Everything we're talking about is for your personal device. You know, the employer is there to protect their devices. We believe, and the data shows, that employees that leverage this type of service and companies that provide cyber education and take other steps reduce the risk of a breach significantly. But it's all about taking proactive steps at the employer level to make sure your employees are covered. So Ultimate is the most obviously sophisticated product providing all of those services. Premier does not include device as an antivirus and other services around device and privacy, but it is a premier product in identity theft in that it's providing all of the three bureau credit reporting, all the monitoring, et cetera. And then Total is just one step below. It's providing many of the same services as Premier, but it's focused on one bureau, one credit bureau reporting versus 3B. So if you're out there, at minimum, you should have the Total product. If you're someone that does a lot of browsing and spends a lot of time on the internet, I would strongly encourage you to move to Ultimate. And then you have coverage that's available at an individual level, and you have coverage that is available at the family level. Family is defined as anyone in a household, unlimited. We're actually changing that because, you know, my mom doesn't live in my house. And so we're going to be changing that our family coverage to say that up to 10 people, regardless of where they live. So you can put mom, you can put grandpa, you can put your kids out there. So that feature will be changing, but the whole idea is put your family members on there, because as you can see, Ultimate Individual is $10.85 for an extra $9. You can have access provided to your spouse, your kids, your parents, your grandparents, et cetera. So those are the key things that I wanted to communicate to you. It's a great benefit that's being brought to you through the network and through M3. I strongly encourage you to look at it. We can provide you detailed information about specific product features and so on. But those were the key things that we wanted to communicate to the audience today. So with that, I am done. Katie, I'll turn it back to you to say anything. And obviously, if we have questions, happy to take those.
Sounds good. Scott, thank you so much for the great information. You know, the concept of cyber wellness may be new, but it is so ingrained in practically every facet of our lives. So you've certainly given us a lot to think about, and I am really thrilled that the collaborative relationship between Aura and M3 and the cooperative network has resulted in a solution for members to improve their cyber wellness and at no cost through February. So that's very exciting.
Exactly. I meant to bring that back up. Yeah, that's important. So please take advantage of that.
Absolutely. I know members will hear about this again at the upcoming annual meeting. So on that note, Dan, I think you have a few thoughts to share to wrap us up.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Scott, for that wonderful presentation. This is indicative of the type of services Cooperative Network is always looking for to bring to our members to make their businesses more safe and successful and secure. So thank you. Please reach out to Cooperative Network or to M3 for additional information. As Katie mentioned, we look forward to seeing and interacting with all our members on a virtual platform on November 17th at 1 p.m. for our 2020 Cooperative Network annual meeting. Thank you, Scott. Thank you, Katie. Thank you to all of our friends at M3 Insurance. Be well, be safe, and we'll look forward to seeing you next time. Thank you.
Awesome. Thanks, Dan. Thanks, Katie. Bye, everybody.